I'm Larry Keyes, and I was in the U.S. Navy. I'm a veteran, and I've been down here a couple times on the research project.
My name is Brian McCormick, and I'm a volunteer at the Human Engineering and Research Laboratory.
Hi, my name is Deepan. I'm a doctoral student here at the Human Engineering Research Laboratories.
Hi, my name is Sarah, and I'm a doctoral student at the Human Engineering Research Laboratories.
If it'll help veterans, or all people really, if it'll help them with their problems, with their limbs, all I can do is come down and do some of the studies. I'm willing to do most anything.
Once I got up here and the researchers told me about, you know, what they were going to do and how it worked, it definitely made me feel more comfortable with what was going to be happening. And then at that point, I really got excited about learning about it, how it worked, and then was really eager to do the study from that point from there.
CAREN, or the computer-assisted rehab environment, is a simulation environment, right? It's a virtual reality system that has other components to it, which makes the experience a little bit more immersive. That's what CAREN does.
People might be familiar with how they make animated movies. It's the exact same technology that they use to make animated movies. We just have a lot less cameras and a lot less markers. But so with those, basically what we can do is we capture this video and we can recreate exactly what the person is doing after they've already left. So we can look at where their big toe is in our space compared to their pinky finger, and we can recreate their entire motion in order to study joint angles, postural stability, postural sway, all kinds of different stuff.
It has a motion platform that's controlled by using a hydraulic pump. And within the platform, it has a dual split belt treadmill. And the split belt treadmill is unique in the sense it gives us a wider range that can accommodate for wheelchairs, right? And so as the pump controls the platform, the treadmill moves along with it. And when somebody's on there, they're looking at the screen which constitutes the virtual environment, right? And while they're moving in this environment, you can track them using motion capture system. And all of this is tied together using one software. This forms a closed loop, but what we mean by that is you can use any one of these systems as an input, another as an output.
When I get on a system here and I think I'm walking about as normal as I can, and I find out that I'm really not. You know, I have a lot to learn that way, because when I think I'm walking normal with a normal stride, I can see in the system that I'm tilting and things that I didn't know I did.
The research that happens here, if it's not one of a kind, it's definitely very unique around the country, and that there's not research like this going on just everywhere. So this is, I think, a very unique location and a very unique opportunity for them to take a look at.
I think it's where we're going in the future, and I think obviously the VA wants to be on the edge of what we're doing. And I think systems like this are going to be paramount in our success in the future of testing technology, because of the wide range of capabilities that you can do with a system like CAREN. I think that it'll be leading us forward with everything that we're doing.
It makes me feel good. You know, if it helps somebody else, especially to me, especially the vets, you know, if I can help them, then so be it.